So I'm going to give a little quick overview of the program, do a little bit of community update before Josh heads into the presentation. So we've got like a little bit of a retracted meetup tonight. We have one presentation that Josh is going to be doing that is building a ride sharing app in Elixir. Thank you very much for that, Josh. So that's going to be around a 20 minute presentation. Is that right? Around that? You can feel free to extend that out a little bit if you like. Yeah. So we want lots of questions. Typically we finish up around 8:30, so we're going to finish a little earlier, probably around 8 o'clock. After the presentation, we'll open up for any announcements. So if there's projects or companies or anything like that you would like to promote, if you're looking for Elixir developers, please feel free to do that then. But first, we'll do a little quick community update. So, whoops, too many hearts for that. All right, let's start here. That's better. Okay, it's January. So I just want to sort of start off talking about how you can contribute to the Elixir community and to the meetup. A little bit of meetup planning, and then we'll do a quick sort of talk about Elixir 1.6, or a quick chat about 1.6. That was actually released today, so we have a so that's out there and available. Don't mind that title, that should actually be contributing. So I just want to sort of talk about, in terms of community and the meetup, that there's a bunch of ways that you can contribute. Obviously, we're always looking for presenters. And certainly, you know, when we started this meetup and started this community, we also wanted to do things beyond doing presentations. So if any of you are interested in doing a workshop type event, if any of you are interested in doing an Elixir Bridge type of event, we would really be happy to help you organize that. We wouldn't necessarily be heading that up, but we would certainly give you any sort of support to do that. So if that sort of interests anyone, please let us know. There's always the Montreal Elixir website that always needs some love. So a good ticket there if you're just getting familiar with Elixir. 1.6 is out, so we would appreciate a PR for updating the Montreal Elixir website, which is a Phoenix application, of course. So, and I think there's also like, I mean, it's looking a little shabby right now, so of course if anyone wants to throw a skin on that, that'd be much appreciated too. For the newcomers, you might not know, but we actually record all of the presentations here, and so there's a bit of video production work that goes on that Hugo's been diligently doing that over the last, since we started the meetup. It would be great if someone would be up to taking over that task. We've got it well documented on the playbook, which is on our GitHub repo. So again, you know, that would be a great way to sort of help us out with hosting this. And then finally, any sort of form of sponsorship, of course, is welcome. So if you're a company that's using Elixir and would like to sponsor pizza and beer, that would be great. And also if you're interested in hosting from a venue point of view, we'd love to talk to you as well. And then we always try to sort of plan this thing 3 months in advance in terms of in terms of presentations. So maybe you're not ready sort of to present the next week, but I highly suggest to commit, maybe you want to present in 2 months time, and then do all the rush in terms of presenting the presentation, organizing the presentation. So looking ahead, we're actually going to take a month off next February. So our next one will be March. February would have been the 14th. So I think maybe there's better things to do on that day. I don't know, maybe, I don't know. All right, so the next one will be in March. We're totally open, so if you're thinking about presenting, please let us know. And of course, April is open as well. So there you go. Happy news, Elixir 1.6 was released today. There's some pretty neat, there's a couple of sort of interesting features in there. If any of you have used Elm, of course, you'd probably like the Elm formatter, and Elixir finally has its own formatter. which is interesting. If you want a little bit of a play around with that, there's the elixirformatter.com where you can have a quick preview of how that works. There's also a dynamic supervisor that was introduced. If you've ever had the experience of adding children dynamically to a supervisor, you'll be using this simple one-for-one strategy. That can, with the simple one-for-one strategy, there's some weird semantics that goes on, so it doesn't necessarily behave exactly the same way when you're using one-for-one or the other strategies, certainly in terms of regards like initialization and shutdown. So they've actually now have a specific dynamic supervisor, which is kind of nice, and they've added other options where you can have a max number of children to that dynamic supervisor. Another feature as well, which I actually quite like, is the you can actually define meaningful guard clauses. So they've introduced the def guard, and there you can, well, as in this example, you can see that you can actually give that guard clause a name and then use it in your function heads. Before that, you would just kind of use these primitives. As example, you know, age greater than or equal to 21, you would have to kind of duplicate that across your code base. But here now you can actually give these meaningful names, intention revealing names. So if you want more details on that, definitely check out elixirlang.org. It has a bunch of other features on there as well. So a little bit of an update tonight. We'll take a quick break and then Josh will get started. But I just wanted to see if there's any questions or suggestions or anything like that. No? Okay. So we'll take a quick break and then we'll get into the presentation. Cheers.